Great start to the season for this Dutch duo. Silver medalists in the FIV World Tour Open event in Luzern. And silver medalists in the Grand Slam in Moscow. So this is a very closely matched competition. So the Dutch won the toss. They're opting to receive serve in the first exchange of the first set. Germany put the ball into play with Laura Ludwig. And that win of the toss and choice to receive gives the Netherlands the first point on the board. Dane, let's get you into the action here. I know you're looking forward to this one. I know you're a little disappointed that either of these teams didn't go through to the final to meet up with the Brazilians.
Absolutely. You never, you know, as a fan, want that country versus country in the final. You want to mix it up. So we do have a spectacular final with both Brazilian teams going against one another. And what I'm curious to see here in this bronze medal final is who can recover. Remember, the Netherlands lost an absolute nail biter in the semifinals, had some great opportunities, but so did Germany. So both these teams coming off tough losses, who can be more prepared mentally?
Both teams trading side outs off service, and this is the way it went in the opening sets. Well, the semi-finals as well.
Not ideal conditions right now as that ball sails out of bounds. We're used to traveling the world playing in very warm climates, you know, 80 degrees, 30 degrees and above Celsius. But right now, currently in Stavanger, we are at 50 degrees Fahrenheit, which translates to about 10 degrees Celsius. So that's why you see these players wearing tights on the bottom to stay warm, keep the muscles warm. I wish I had a pair up in the broadcast booth. It's pretty chilly out here.
That's good words. Well, a little bit of help from Ludwig on the net there gives Germany a 3-2 lead over Holland. Oh, yes. Very nice shot there from Meppelink, the number two for Holland. And her teammate, Van Ursel, wearing one, will serve. 3-3. Marlene Van Ursel, just 27 years of age, from Amsterdam. Oh, look at that big, powerful spinning jump serve with a little help from the net as well. Ludwig hits that way too hard. Point goes to Dutch, and here's the first side switch.
Ludwig up big. She tries to go line. It's an open shot right there, but she fails to execute, just hitting the ball about 3 feet wide. Sometimes you don't want to be that particular. She's going to have to hone that one in and calibrate her shot.
Van Ursel with a service. Ludwig sets for... Oh, what a great block at the neck there from Meppelink, but doesn't get it the second time. Ludwig sees the gap and puts the ball away.
The Netherlands have really had a great tournament. You know, they won their pool, they went right through, and then they had a difficult semifinal where they had some great opportunity. They're probably kicking themselves, thinking they should be in that final. Look at this play. It almost rests on Meppelink.
Ludwig up now on the attack. Oh, and this time she hits it right into the tape of the net, but it falls the German side, not the Dutch. The Netherlands take the lead, 5-4.
Look how fortunate the Netherlands are right there, kind of a chest dig, an emergency play, and then Germany has an opportunity here, but instead of coming aggressive, it's the little roll shot that ends up in the net for Ludwig.
25-year-old Meppelink with service. Oh, service error. She'll kick herself for that mistake. Allows Germany to even the scores at 5-5. Laura Ludwig to serve. Falkenhorst sets for Ludwig. Oh, it's a good save from Van Ursel. Ludwig tries again. Oh, that's a shot that she performed on a number of occasions in the semi-finals. A super fine cut shot.
And she gets blocked, and then on the second opportunity, instead of trying to blast the ball through the blocker at the net, she tries the little cut shot, which she is so proficient at.
Ludwig it is with service. Oh, that is a really tricky serve. off the hands of Volkenhorst, allows the Netherlands to level the scores again.
Well, that's what you want to do as a server. Serve the ball deep, serve the ball short. The short serve comes in from Germany, and the Netherlands are able to make the adjustments, and that's what great teams do.
Van Issel with the service. That big, powerful, spinning jump serve. Just a little too much power on that one.
I like that Van Issel's going for it. Remember, she was the 2010 FIVB best server, so she's got quite a weapon from that service line. She takes risks. Unfortunately, that last one was out.
Falkenstein sets Falkenhorst, I should say, sets for Ludwig.
Stuff block right there. Little side switch. Both teams really trying to figure one another out right now as we're deadlocked at 7. The nice block up at the net by Meppelink at 6 feet. So she's got the leverage and she wins the point. Ludwig.
And Ludwig takes service. Van Issel on the attack for Holland. It's a good save. And Ludwig tries to push it to the back of the court. Meppelink gives the Germans no touch choice but to put it back on the first. Oh, and that's out! Was it a touch? Questions for the referee.
No touch
at all.
Van Issel not happy, going to the second referee, pleading her case. She wanted a touch call. Look at the replay. Is there a touch? Oh, it's just too hard to call. Didn't touch that little pinky finger on the left hand of Volkenhorst or not. We will never know. Should be interesting. I think in the future we will see instant replay in volleyball. Of course, we don't have that currently, but you never know in the future.
I think it's only a matter of time, Dave. It's a good point that you make. Also, the speed of the ball in the serve is something that we're told technology is going to bring us. Hopefully next season, who knows, maybe at the end of this, when we go to Fort Lauderdale in September for the Swatch Beach Volleyball FIVB World Tour Finals.
Here's another angle on the replay, and we can't catch it right there either. So I believe no touch. I believe the correct call was made by the referee and the linesman.
9-7 to Germany. See if that timeout has just stopped a little of the momentum called by the Dutch team. Each team allowed to call 1 30-second timeout in each set. Back to the German service with Laura Ludwig. Floats the ball. And a good block from Volkenhorst.
Falkenhurst really looking solid with her blocking form right now. She's being disciplined. She's not trying to take too much area. She's taking the area that she calls, and right there, she shuts down that line hit.
Germany go three clear, right to the middle of the Dutch players. Meppelink down the line in the alleyway for the Dutch. Number two.
Right down the alley, in between the left arm and the antenna. It's a precise shot by Meppelink. If you're blocking line, you've got to seal that up. You can't allow the offensive player to have that little alley.
10-8 to Germany with Van Issel, Marlene Van Issel serving. Big power serve once again. Volkenhorst this time is blocked by Meppelink at the net, given a piece of her own medicine. A very important side out for, very important point score, I should say, for the Dutch.
Well, going back and forth, one block each so far. It's going to be a duel at the net. Who can be more effective blocking, Meppelink or Volkenhorst?
Marlene Van Issel with a service once again. Volkenhorst on the attack. Here's the set for Meppelink. Oh, and a 2 out of 2 for Kira Volkenhorst. That'll boost her confidence.
A great read by Volkenhorst. She sees that Van Issel wants to go angle, and she's able to press over with that left hand and barely get the ball to stay on the Netherlands side.
Oh, a service error way too deep. That was playing into the wind as well, so timeout called.
As we take this technical timeout, let me explain what's going on here. Obviously, we've talked about the weather. It's a little colder than normal conditions. We also have a nice little breeze on the court, so that creates a good side and a bad side. The good side is when you have the wind in your face. Then you can really go for it with your serve, and it's going to end up still in the court. If that wind is at your back, it's much harder to keep the ball in. Your high, deep shots to the corner end up going long and out of bounds. So you want to be on the good side. And from the TV viewer's perspective, the right side of the court is considered the good side. The left side of the court is considered the bad side. You have to take advantage when you're on the good side. And right now, the Netherlands are on that side.
Well, let's see how that unfolds after the technical timeout at 21 points. And it is Holland to serve. Madeleine Meppelink puts the ball to Valkenhorst. Ludwig sets for Valkenhorst. But at the net, great work from Meppelink to level the scores.
Here comes Valkenhorst, but Ludwig set a little bit too tight. That's what you have to be careful. It's a 1 or 2 feet difference, and if you put it too tight, the blocker has the advantage.
Good shot from Kira Valkenhorst.
This is a battle. Here, this time, Ludwig puts the ball in a better position for Valkenhorst to hit it, and that's a couple feet off the net. You don't want it on top of the net. You want a couple feet on your side.
Oh, that's her favorite shot. We saw it work to her advantage a couple of times in the semis. It went against her a couple of times. But I think with that kind of success, we'll be seeing that first ball shot more often, Dan.
Of course, we'll keep track of that. She's one for one on going on that first contact. Great vision. If you see it and can execute it, go for it.
Good shot by Meppelink.
Here you see an on-two situation. First we saw Ludwig go over on one, now we see the Netherlands go over on the second contact. Remember, you have three contacts that you can use. Doesn't mean you have to use them, but three at most. You can go over on the first or second, as we have just seen on the last two plays.
Van Ursel with a big, powerful serve. Ludwig struggling a little to contain it, but oh, that's out! And Germany go to clear, 14-12.
Meppelink tried to put down that precise shot, but she's twisting and turning in the air. She doesn't line it up correctly and misses just barely.
Kira Valkenhorst with service for Germany.
Look out for the Netherlands.
Solid by Van Ursel right there. Using the block, going right at Valkenhorst, and that ball ricocheting out. Kids having a great time with those clappers that they've given to pretty much every fan.
This is at Madeleine Meppelink with the service. Now here's Valkenhorst on the attack. Nice touch, nice timing. And Germany maintains their 2-point advantage. Side switch.
Valkenhorst, one of the taller players on tour at 6 feet. She comes in and shows she's just not a powerful player. She has that finesse too, out of reach of Van Ursel.
Ludwig with a service. No, that's not a good serve for Ludwig. A little frustrating.
We're about at that point, Nick, where great teams start to switch gears and really turn it up. Remember, unforced errors after 15 become accentuated even more. You have to play really high level.
Oh! How about that? Van Ursel giving Ludwig a piece of her own medicine, taking it on the first ball.
I like it. She commits. She's laying it out, sacrificing her whole body, and with that right hand is able to place it deep in the court, and that is going to force a timeout by the Germans. It's an interesting timeout, if you ask me. Of course, the Netherlands did score 2 points right there, but we're deadlocked at 15. This thing's going to get more interesting, and I would have kept that timeout in my pocket for when we get closer to 19-20 if you need it. But you never know. You have to know your team and your partner when is a good time to call a timeout. And we've seen some great timing with calling timeouts, especially in the semifinals. We saw the Netherlands make a great timeout, come out, score 3 in a row. Whatever it takes to get that momentum back on your side, you want to do it. So, smart play. Remember, one timeout per team per set, so you better use it wisely.
Here's Van Aerssel with the service. All tied at 15-all in the first set. Katrina McCormick-Meyer gives the whistle to continue with the match. Service for the Netherlands. Oh, Vulcan Horst, I should say. Just getting caught at the net there. She's been successful with that shot a couple of times, but not for the third time of asking.
You think after a timeout that you'd come out really aggressive right there. She goes with a finesse shot, tries to make it too sharp, and it ends up staying on the German side of the net.
Another good service from Van Aerssel.
Oh, and this time too much power from Vulcanhorst. And in a matter of seconds, now the Dutch have the advantage by 2 over Germany.
That timeout definitely not working for Germany. They came out of the timeout, and it seemed like it gave the Netherlands more of a boost than themselves.
Here's Ludwig on the attack for Germany. Oh, a great block and a second from Meppelink. Can she make it 3 out of 3? Yes, she can! That is great work.
Remember, what did I say? The blocking battle at the net would be very important with Vulcanhorst and Meppelink. Right now, Meppelink is just timing it perfect. Even if it's not a stuff block all the way to the sand, she's blocking it, she's putting up a wall, and she's causing all sorts of frustration for the Germans.
This time, the ball is wide. A little too long this time. Germany pull one back, but are 16-18 against the Netherlands.
Just need to side out point for point here now, and Germany are in trouble. Here come the Dutch on the attack. Meppelink,
very good work again. Spikes it down to the sand, and the set is looking good. Set number one, that is, for Holland.
The Dutch playing at a very high level. They're not making any unforced errors. Anytime they don't think they can get a winner, they're keeping the ball in the court rather than hitting it out and giving Germany more chances to make mistakes, and it's working. decides to switch it up. That throws Van Ursel a little bit out of balance and off guard and goes for the open court.
Van Ursel up at the net.
Not quite got the timing there with the block for Valkenhorst.
Here you see Valkenhorst time it, get up, but she's still on her way up when that ball's hit. She has to jump a little bit earlier. It's just a split second that can be the difference.
Marlene Van Ursel. Too big, too deep, too long.
Germany holds on to its three-point advantage. They need to win this second set.
Lara Ludwig with service. Great shot again from Meppelink.
Right now, Germany playing a little bit more consistent, and you expect that because I would believe that they're playing with a little bit more of a sense of urgency after losing set number one.
Good shot again from Ludwig. Taking her time there, watching the opposition before she made her play.
Look at this set by Valkenhorst. And then the nice roll shot, making it look easy, is Laura Ludwig.
Kira Valkenhorst serves for Germany. Van Ursel now attacking at the net. Good cut shot to take the point for the Netherlands.
Like a chess match right now. High-level volleyball going back and forth. When you're on defense, you're looking for tendencies. You're looking for where that offensive player is going to hit the ball, where their patterns are, where they like to hit it. And as the set goes on, you try to make them pay for going to their favorite spots.
Marlene Van Ursel serves into the net. Germany back to the three-point advantage. Ludwig walked to the back of the court to prepare for her service. Ludwig.
Laura Ludwig takes Germany 4 points clear of the Netherlands.
Ludwig all over the court, making a great defensive play, and then more importantly, getting the set from Valkenhorst and able to put it away as they extend this lead.
Great save from Valkenhorst. Can she finish it? Meppelink now sets it up.
Oh, good shot from Van Ursel.
Amazing rally.
Solid play right there, getting out of trouble. Seems like the Netherlands are having a little bit of trouble passing the ball and getting their offense set up. That's providing Germany some opportunities. And I'll tell you what, Germany needs to really exploit those opportunities because we've seen at any time the Netherlands can strike and get themselves right back in it. And here it comes right now. A second point in a row for the Netherlands. So look out. That's a result of a pass that's a little bit too tight to the net. Ludwig decides to try to hit on two, and it's not the right decision this time.
Meppelink to serve. Valkenhorst. Good shots.
Very important. Point for Germany. Keeping that 3 point advantage.
There, the blocker is taking angle. The defender is also in the angle, so they completely leave the line unguarded. Another tough pass, and what happens? The attack goes into the net. So Germany winning the serving battle. It's not going to show up in the stat book because they're not aces, but they're getting the Netherlands in trouble. They're not passing that first ball correctly, making it difficult to get the setup, and then their attack is in no position to win the point. Another tough pass. They get out of trouble this time.
Unlucky that for Volkenhorst, but no question. Germany are looking good to take this second set. Technical timeout at 21 points.
You want to really use this technical timeout to get your breath back, have a drink, relax, but most importantly, to communicate. If you want to make any adjustments on the court, it's best to communicate it now while you have your partner's full attention. Once you get out on the court, so many things are happening. So important to communicate, especially since you don't have a coach in your corner. And I really like that about beach volleyball, that there is no coach. Yeah. So they have coaches, but they're not allowed right there in the box. So you have to make your own decisions.
Give a big hand to the ladies, and now, boys and girls, clap your hands for both teams and the bronze medal.
Well, we're also going to have to start discussing Dane's physical fitness in just a short while if this does go to three. Let's not forget that the Netherlands went a very long three-set match, over an hour's play earlier this morning in their semi-final against Giuliana and Antonelli. Just 43 minutes of play in a two-setter for the Germans.
Lucky one.
Lucky one for the Dutch there to pull it back to just two.
Anytime that ball clips the top of the net, it's live, that let serve rule, and it usually works to the advantage of the server. That time doesn't clear the net. It's not something you really try to do as a player, but if you can get it close to the top of the net and get fortunate enough for it to roll over, it can cause some trouble for the players on the other side.
Ludwig with the service, Meppelink.
A little quick offense there for the Netherlands. Instead of traditionally setting the ball high, this is kind of shot outside a little lower than normal. That's to try to catch that blocker off guard. If you can mix it up so the blocker is not in an optimum position, you have the advantage on offense.
Oh, what a great save from Van Ursel. And again, two spectacular digs. Volkenhorst tries for a third time. Oh, and a third time unsuccessful. Great defensive play. Credit where it's due from Arlene Van Ursel, but Germany take the point.
Van Ursel everywhere. Look at this left-handed stab. Gets it up in the air. And then right here, a beautiful cut shot by Volkenhorst, but Van Ursel is still in position. She's a great defender. What I love about her is that she goes for every single ball. She doesn't make a decision. She just pursues. And she gets up, I'm sure, a lot of the balls that she might not even think that she can get there. That's the thing on defense. You just have to go for it, don't think about it, and you get up a lot of hits that even you don't think you can pull off.
They're still in the second set, the Dutch, and if they take it, then the match is over and they'll walk away with the bronze medal. That's a great service from Van Ursel. Ludwig attacking at the net, pokes the ball over the top of Meppelink. Maintaining their two-point advantage. Germany has to win this second set to stay in the match. The Dutch are close, and this is the time to start turning on the heat and pressure. Ludwig with service for Germany. Meppelink serves it up for Van Ursel. Oh, right on the line. Great shot.
Really precise shot. Difficult. The set was a little off the net. She had to go deep in the court because Volkenhorst was right in her line. And a beautiful shot.
Side twitch. Dutch are playing into the wind. Can that just give them a little edge to try and level the scores and go ahead here? Ludwig sets for Volkenhorst. Good time. Good shot.
So a good position for the Germans, being up 16-13. Remember, in set number one, we were deadlocked at 15. They have a bit of an edge right now. The question is, can they play consistent enough to hold on to this lead? Because you know the Netherlands are going to make a push.
Good block from Volkenhorst. Ludwig again, a good dig. This time the blocking from Nepellink. Oh, and Germany take a very valuable point indeed.
Nepellink just owning the net. She's just a wall, continuing to block. Fortunately for Germany, that one goes out of bounds, and Nepellink knows she missed one just barely.
4 points clear.
Playing with the wind, Volkenhorst serves for Germany. Here's the set for Nepellink. Ludwig picks it up quite nicely. Ludwig now looks to finish it, and this is good news for Germany.
Well on their way now, five clear to taking the second set and taking the match to three sets.
They're playing aggressive. They're beating the Netherlands to the punch. An interesting decision for Nepellink to drop in that situation, and Ludwig just blasted at her.
Both sides have run out of timeouts, so...
Netherlands get one back. The serve was too long from Kira Volkenhorst. Germany looking confident. Can the Netherlands get back into the second set and wrap it up and take the bronze?
Marlene van Essel with service.
Oh, and it just slides down the German side of the net.
Well, this is the push that we were waiting for from the Netherlands. Van Essel with a tough serve. Balkenhorst comes in with a soft shot. Instead of being aggressive, that one into the bottom of the net. Can the Netherlands keep this run going and get back into this one?
Van Essel again with service. Good jump serve. Ludwig now attacking for Germany.
And that's a valuable point. 19-15.
Nepellink just laid on this block. Look, she's just on her way up, not pressing over with that left hand, and it's just a split second where she's not sealing the net.
Ludwig is serving to keep Germany in this match here. Oh, the Germans have no answer to that one.
Just a rifle of an arm right there by Van Essel, just letting loose, playing aggressive. She knows that the Netherlands have that one set in their pocket, but they would much rather finish this thing up in two rather than go three sets.
Nepellink with service. Van Essel.
Oh, lift violation.
Oh, and net violation from the Dutch player, which gives Germany second set point.
Yeah. On this block, it looks like maybe a lift is called when she tries to cover it. Nice block by Volkenhorst, and then an open hand move upward. The referee signals for a lift.
Here of Volkenhorst.
Not there for the Dutch. And Germany are in the match, 21-16, taking set two, taking it to a third set, only to 15, remember.
Final play was interesting. I don't know if she tried to go over the net, aired, it ended up in the net. Nepellink tried to set it, but Van Essel trying to get the quick one over. The Netherlands kind of looked out of sorts in that second set, not as sharp as they were in the first set, almost as if they knew they could relax for a minute and maybe play a little more relaxed might help them, but it didn't work out.
A
Well, the stats pretty even except for 9 service errors against 5 for the German duo. 21-16 the final score. We'll take this to a third and final set to decide the bronze medal at the Swatch Beach Volleyball Major here in Stavanger City, Norway. And I wouldn't want to bet on either. This could go either team's way. It really is. Germany or the Netherlands for the taking. If the Netherlands can bring the power play that they showed in the first set, Germany are in trouble. But again, Germany digging deep in that second set to stay in the match. If they can bring that confidence to this third set, Germany could pick off their best result of the 2015 season.
I really like the way Germany turned things around in that second set. I was curious as to how they would respond. They came out, you know what, and they jumped all over the Netherlands early. Remember that timeout at 4-1. If they can jump on the Netherlands again early, I think they'll be in great shape. But this Netherlands team is not the European champions by mistake. They know how to play in tough matches. Of course, they have won tournaments. And they're looking to get back on track. Remember, a difficult finish last week in Portage. Now, if they could get back on the podium, that would be very successful rebound from that tough finish a week ago. I'm looking forward. If I had to make a prediction, I think the Netherlands are going to come out early and try to jump on these Germans.
They're going to look for their third medal of the 2015 season so far. Let's not forget the Dutch had to go 3 sets in their semi-final earlier this morning. It's going to go 3 sets in this bronze medal match here right now. Van Aerssel does well to keep the ball up. Sky ball from Meppelink. Not the best of sets either from Valkenhorst. That didn't really help. Ludwig gave the Netherlands a golden opportunity, and they put the first point on the board.
Smart play by the Netherlands. They don't have a winner, so they just kind of skyball it over the net, and then the pass is errant by Valkenhorst. Ludwig has to try to go on too, and the Netherlands know they dodged a billet. Very important for them to get on the board first.
Marleen Van Aerssel with service for the Dutch here. She's targeting Valkenhorst, no question there with both the serves. But Germany has the reply.
Good side out by Valkenhorst. I think she's going to get the majority of serves here, as she has previous to this point, because the Netherlands have manufactured a couple of points off of her.
Laura Ludwig with service for Germany. Oh, trying to take it on the first contact. No success.
It looked like she was a bit out of balance on that one and kind of committed and had to go for it. Ended up a little bit long, unfortunately, for Ludwig.
Madeline Meppelink with the service. Is Valkenhorst attacking at the net? Very nice little poked ball over the top of both the Dutch players.
I like that. We call that the rainbow shot because it's got that rainbow arc. The defender is playing the angle a little too shallow, and then you just rainbow it. You freeze the defender, and all Van Aerssel can do is watch.
Kira Valkenhorst with service for Germany. We're all tied at 2-2 in the third and final set, but it's only to 15. You have to win by 2 clear points. Meppelink. Oh, is Ludwig tight now at the net?
Too tight a set right there. Germany had the free ball situation, but we've seen that twice already in the third set where they haven't been able to pass the ball correctly. It puts the setter in a lot of trouble, and it gives the blocker the advantage.
Dane, it's almost as if for a split second the Germans can't believe their luck. And because they've got so much time and such an easy option on their hands, then they sort of lose their drills and skills for that short moment and fail to take advantage. Great recovery from Meppelink at the net.
Another tight set, but that time Valkenhorst gets away with it. Ludwig knows she's setting the ball a little bit too tight, but Valkenhorst, 6 foot, getting up big at 184 centimeters.
Laura Ludwig, all tied at 3-3. Van Aerssel
Oh, this time, Kira Volkenhorst takes full advantage of that 184-centimeter height and reach.
Well, this time the Netherlands set the ball a little too tight, and then Volkenhorst gets the advantage. You're seeing how much 1 or 2 feet difference can make when you're setting that ball.
Oh, that's a disappointment. That was a golden opportunity for Germany to break the Netherlands there. Here's Madeleine Meppelink with the serve. She's just 25 years of age from The Hague. Oh, and there's another one thrown away. Service errors from both sides back to back.
Yeah, no one's really been able to get an edge here in this third set. Someone's going to have to start taking risks. And there it is, a great serve by Volkenhorst. That puts the Netherlands in trouble. So taking a risk with a nice, shallow float serve puts the Netherlands in trouble. Germany now with a nice 2-point lead. Why Ludwig ended up at the net. Remember, she's the full-time defender. Usually Volkenhorst is at the net, so maybe a little confusion there, but beautiful defense by Ludwig keeping that ball in play.
Van Ursel with service. Volkenhorst sets Ludwig, cuts the ball with absolute precision. 7-5, holding on to that 2-point advantage.
Such beautiful deception. She baits Van Ursel into going to the line, then she hits an angle. No defender within 10 feet. Beautiful shot by Ludwig.
Absolute commitment from Germany, just failing to keep the ball up there.
Yeah, beautiful hustle, and when you have hustle like that, you never know when you're going to get the point to go your way. Balkenhorst with a beautiful stop in the block position. Then she tries to pop the ball up, but can't get it in a good position for Ludwig to hit it over.
The Dutch pull one back. Madeleine Meppelink with serve.
Oh, wow. That ball, I think that's the first we've seen here in this tournament. The ball did not even make it to the net right there. Talk about trying to go for a short serve. I'll tell you what, the Netherlands have not looked as sharp as they were in the first set. Germany is outplaying them at the moment.
Looking a little tired, I'd say. Here's Van Ursel up at the net. Lovely cross-court spike. Side switch.
Yeah, and when I say that, I mean, they play it at a high level, but we know their potential, and I don't believe that they're playing at that full level right now. They can turn it around at any time. They've shown that to us before, but they have to focus in on closing out. Remember, this is the number 2 team in the tournament versus the number 12 team in Germany.
Good play to level the scores. Valuable point for the Dutch. They had the Germans out of position from the get-go.
Going over on two is Meppelink, putting it down. But you know, Nick, the paper doesn't matter. Number 2 versus number 12. Once you play the game, you throw all that out, and you can see how equal these two teams are.
Good shot from Volkenhorst. Keeping Germany's lead at 9-8 with number 1, Laura Ludwig, to serve. A little too long, serving into the wind.
Wow, this one really coming down to the wire. Back to back, they just keep evening the score. Remember, who wants to take more risks and who wants to be aggressive? That will be the difference here down the stretch.
Meppelink with service.
Ludwig sets for Volkenhorst. Oh, off the fingertips. Takes it on to... Yes, good work. And it's the first time for a while that the Dutch have taken the lead in this third set.
And this is aggressive play. The touch on the block, then the nice setup. And then Meppeling, instead of shooting that ball, she goes aggressive. And what happens when you're aggressive? You score points.
Van Ursel now looks to put the Dutch two ahead. Ludwig sets for Volkenhorst of Germany. Here's a second time for Van Ursel. And it's there! 11-9. The table is turned.
Well, they got this one to fall, but two opportunities by the Dutch. Both of them are poke shots. Remember what happened at 19-20 in their semifinal. They did some poke shots, and it didn't turn out. I'd like to see them be more aggressive, but nonetheless, the Dutch get a two-point lead, and they're sitting pretty right now, looking pretty solid.
Three very valuable point scores in a row, giving Germany no option but to call that timeout to try and stop the rhythm, break the focus and concentration pattern of the Dutch. Meppelink on the left of your screens, Van Eersen on the right, the European champions looking to show the world why they are the European champions. So close in a three-setter with the Brazilians. Can they get the better of the Germans here and grab the bronze at the Swatch Beach Volleyball Major in Stavanger City, Norway? So this is it now. These are the crunch points. We're right down to the business end of proceedings. The Netherlands or Germany? It's Meppelink with service for the Dutch. Germany are trailing by two. Right to the feet of Volkenhorst, who comes back up to attack. Off the fingertips of Van Eersel. And that timeout call pays dividends for Germany. They pull one back. Now 11-10 to the Dutch, or 10-11, Germany to serve. And it's the youngster, just 24 years of age from Hamburg, Kira Volkenhorst with service. Meppelink sets it up for Van Eersel. Smashes it into the block. The block is deflected out of court. It's a two-point advantage once again for the Dutch.
I like that play by Van Eersel. She came in aggressive. She put the pressure on Volkenhorst and ends up with the point. So if the Netherlands can continue to receive, serve well, they'll continue to have this two-point edge.
Ludwig sets once again. Oh, what a great reply from the Dutch. And Ludwig.
No touch on the block right there. So four contacts is called on Germany. It looked like it might have come over the net, but immediately you saw Meppelink say, no, I did not touch that ball. It was just hit hard into the net.
And in a matter of seconds, the game turns Holland's way. Three clear at 13-10. Volkenhorst again up at the net against Meppelink. And it's a good one, right down the alley. Very important spike, a very important point on the board.
Such a big hit by Volkenhorst. A year ago after this tournament, she decided to shut it down due to injury, had to take 6 months off. This team of Volkenhorst and Ludwig have reunited, and she would love to get on that podium.
Wow, well, she's putting down her marker here. That was such a big point for Germany. And it literally keeps them in the match. Now trailing the Dutch by just one. Side switch. Ludwig will serve into the wind.
Great players step up in big situations. And right now, Volkenhorst trying to make it happen for Germany.
The German number one, Ludwig, serves the ball into play. Meppelink sets it up for Van Eersel. Oh, what a great block. And Ludwig levels the scores at 13-all. Germany are going to fight to the wire on this one.
That was absolutely awesome. Textbook defense. Laura Ludwig gets in the slot. She doesn't flinch. She digs it overhand. And then more importantly, she's aggressive. She puts that ball away without shooting it. And that's what it takes to earn that 13th point.
Ludwig showing her experience and quality here. We're all tied at 13. It's another, oh, just ever so slightly deep serve, which gives the Dutch. The Netherlands have done it. Their third medal of the 2015 season. Silver in Luzerne, silver in Moscow, bronze in Stavanger. What a rally to wrap up the bronze medal here on centre court.